As students, we are going to discuss about assignment operator. In this operators, so you can able to see the variety of operators are available here. So that is equal to is nothing but assign the value. Okay, so left value and right value. So it will going to take two operands. That is, assignment operators will going to two operands. Like suppose example, you can able to take x is equal to 25, y is equal to 14. So if you want, I will take it the same values. No problem. So this operator, it is assignment operator. It will going to assign some value. Whatever the value is there at the right side, so that right side value will be assigned to left side value, left side variable. So that is what exactly. If the right side value, whatever the value is there, that value will be assigned to the left side variable. That is what exactly. Y value will be assigned to the x. So this is what we will call it as assign the values to particular variable. Okay, assign y value to x. Again, here you can able to see the operators plus is equal to. Is equal to is nothing but part. I wanted to increment the operator. Okay, so which operator I wanted to increment the operand value. So which operand value? Left operand value I wanted to increase. You can able to see here plus is equal to plus assignment operator we have used. We are using here x plus is equal to y. Nothing but what? So it gives the meaning saying that increase the variable value, nothing but variable which is available at the left side. So that is x. So I wanted to increase the value of x by adding the value y. So that is, it gives the full meaning like this, x is equal to x plus y. So same thing here also, minus assignment. So it indicates x minus is equal to y is nothing but x wanted to increase the value with by adding or subtracting. So nothing but x is equal to x minus y. Same thing we want to follow for here, multiplication operator is equal to asterisk, that is x asterisk equal to y, nothing but x is equal to x star y. Again, x is equal to x divided by y, x is equal to x modulo of y. So like this, you can able to see these are all the assignment operators. We will want to write a program on this. So here we have taken the variable, you can able to see the variable here. So these variables, a is equal to 25, again b is equal to 14. First, what I will want to do, I will going to print the value of a. So let's build it and run it. You can able to see a is equal to 25 here. But what I will going to do now, I will going to assign the value to a so that the value of a will going to be changed here. Nothing but in the memory location. So the current value is 25, that will be changed to 14. Like that it will going to happen. I will show you that one. So just I will going to copy this one. If you want, I will show you directly over here. So that is better, I think. So here, so what I'm going to do, a is equal to b. So finally, the a value will be updated here. So I will show you that one. See, a value is updated, that is equal to 14. This is how you will want to do the, use the assignment operator here. So next, what I will want to do, so as per the diagram, we have seen the operator, how it works, all those things. So let's, what I will want to do now, I will going to increment the value. Currently the value of a is 14 because see, I assigned the value of a to b value. Okay, b value I assigned to a. So that is what, so that's why what I will want to do, I increment the value with b. So what is the current value of a? That is 14. Again, what is the current value of b value? That is also 14. Okay, because why a is 14? Because already, so let's show you. You can able to see this one. Since before the a value was 25. Okay, so here I will say that a, before a value was 25, now I assign the value for a. What is that value? We have assigned the value b value. Now the current value is 14. Okay, so a value, current value is 14. So a is equal to, current value of a is 14. So keep it in mind. Okay, so let's go a little bit further here. When you go what to do, so build it and run it. So you can able to see the current value of a is 14, but the value of a is equal to 28. Nothing but a value got updated here. 14 plus 14, what is the value you will want to get it? A value is 14 because the current value of a is 14 as well as b value is also 14. So a plus a, so we got the value, that is what is that? 28. That is what? Let me build once again. So you can able to see 28. Okay, so compare and run it. Here also you make next line. So that's why. See, 28, got it. So this is one good example. Again, what we'll want to do here, we, so I will want to copy this one. So I will copy this statement. So what I do here, okay, so now what is the current value of a? That is 28. Okay, so we have updated the value a plus b, so the current value got updated. If you don't want, means you can able to do like that also. So for that, what I will want to do, if you don't want to update, no problem, just I will do like this. Okay, so just I will want to do like this. So now the current value of a is 25. So what I will want to do, I will want to subtract this one, minus 25. Okay, so a is equal to 20, a is equal to a minus b. So that is the expression you will want to get it here. A is equal to a minus b. So when you do this, a minus b, what is the value of a is 25 minus 14. So you will want to get the value. Let's see that one. It's 11. So 11 is the answer. Okay, this is one thing we did. Again, what I will want to do further, we will want to do some more. I will want to paste here. So we have done with the addition as well as subtraction. So we will go for multiplication here. Okay, stop. So what is the current value of a is 25 into 14. Okay, so what it the expressions looks like this. A is equal to a star b. Nothing but what? A into b. What is the value of a? 25 into 14. So we are going to say this one. See, we are getting 350 is the answer. So this is how it will going to work here. So again, so we will want to see the next expression as well. Again, I don't want to update because if I will show you when you update that one, what happens? I will show you. Don't worry. No need to worry about that. So now I will want to take one more here. So that is already we have completed this one, divide by. Okay, so here, so when you divide, I will going to say divide, so you will going to get some floating point numbers. So for the two small changes, what I will going to do, I will going to make this one as f because floating point. Okay, so that's fine. So if you want, you can able to write like this 2f, like this also no problem, doesn't matter. The current, the expression looks like this. A is equal to A divided by B. That's it. What is the value of A? That is 25 divided by 14. So it will going to give you the value. Dividend value. We are going to get it. So you can able to see you people are getting 0, 0, but I will show you. So why? Just a moment. But I want. So because the type conversion is not happening, so what I will do here, I will say float. So can I do like this? If I do type conversion, so maybe I will want it. So note it. Just I will put this one also in the bracket. Yes or not? So that is one you people are getting. Okay, 14 ones are, so 14 ones are something like this. You want to get it. Suppose if you want it exact answer, okay, so you make it 28, so then you see you're going to get the exact answer. No need to use all this type conversion, etc. So just you make it as percentage d over here, so then build it and run it. So that's it. Again, so we have one more, that is reminder. So same thing I will going to use it here. So basically when you divide by these things, you will going to get the remainder. Finally, so what I want to do here, I will put the remainder in. So that is modulo. So nothing but part. So the expression looks like this. When you the meaning of this, A is equal to A the modulus of B. So nothing but take the value of A, divide by B. Again, what is the remainder you are going to get it? Show that remainder. Okay, that is what exactly. Let's see this one also. So that is 2. So remainder is you people are getting 2. Okay, just what I will do, I will want to comment this one because we are getting the different answers. So that, so let me build it and run it. No, sorry. So this one, let me build it and read it. You will want to get the A is equal to 0. So now what I will want to do, I will want to remove all the comments. Okay, I will want to remove all the comments. Okay, fine. Now, so whatever the values you will going to get it. So all those values are updated values of A. Okay, so maybe you will going to get some different answers, but that is all the values you will going to get is that is update of A. A value is got updated. So please go through and verify this one. So this is all about assignment operator. Thank you.